The light of Christ joins us this morning for worship.
Good morning and welcome. We are glad you have joined in worship with First Christian Lawrenceburg this day. And no matter where you live, or who you love, or what sins you think you have committed, you are welcomed here. We are disciples of Christ, a movement for wholeness in a fragmented world. As part of the one body of Christ, we welcome all to the Lord's table, as God has welcomed us. This morning, our worship may look a little different. We have recorded in different locations this week. Earlier this week, we were uncertain as what the weather would cause, and so we decided to film this from various locations. And another very important reason is I wanted to give our excellent tech team a well-deserved Sunday off. We appreciate all of their gifts so much. So if you find something wrong with the service today, don't blame the tech team, blame me, for I am the one who produced this service. May it be a blessing to you this day. Today there will be no Pray and Play or Cairo CYF. We are starting a baptism class in March, and if you know of a young person who is interested in learning more about baptism, please contact Mike about participating. We welcome to worship today Shay Locke, sharing her beautiful voice during our witness through music time. Today is the first Sunday of Lent. The liturgical color for Lent is purple, signifying repentance and preparation. We give thanks for our beautiful new pyramids, pulpit and lectern scarves, some may call them. And we give thanks also to Mary Sparrow and to Rhonda Frank and crew for the beautiful display for our Lenten theme, Holy Vessels. Each of us is created a precious and holy vessel of embodied love. We have been through a distressing time since last Lent that has shattered our sense of wholeness, body, mind, and spirit. Like a glass vessel shattered and fractured into pieces, let us enter this Lent and claim it as a season of recovery, as we focus on Jesus, the healer of every ill. Let us worship together.
Holy and whole, grow.
Let us hear these words of assurance. Know this, God's love and grace surround you, no matter what. You are a precious and holy vessel right now. Christ's light is a treasure given freely for you, for me, for all. Let us be drawn to the healer, opening our hearts with honesty about our lives and finding assurance that offers peace. In Christ, we are forgiven, healed, and made whole. Come to our time of offering this morning, we are reminded of the holy vessel that we are, that we get to be God's vessel on this earth to share who we are and whose we are with all that we meet. And we do that by sharing our time, our talent, and our treasure. We share those things so that others may experience God the way that we see God as well. You know, it's a chance for us as a church to come and share in this Lenten season, to be reminded that what we give back to God is so important. So I hope during this Lenten season that you can find what is God's, that you can share that with God today. You may give your gifts via our PushPay online giving app or through dropping off or mailing your church offering to the church office. Let us pray. We are called to share the gifts God has given us with the people of God. So in this Lenten season, let us offer what we have for others, both near and far, for building up the realm of God on earth. God of mercy and grace, thank you for this time of sharing our gifts and resources while we mark this season's beginning. May your realm continue to come near, even as we daily seek to repent and believe in the good news which Jesus proclaimed. Amen. As we open our time of joys and concerns this morning, we ask you to the following people in your thoughts and prayers throughout this day and this week ahead. The family of Betty Grace Parrish, who passed from this life to eternal life on Tuesday. Betty is the mother of Warren, who's married to Margaret Gray. A celebration of life will be held at a later date. The family of Bud Watts, who passed from this life to eternal life on Tuesday. Please remember his daughters, Julie McKee and Holly Watts. A celebration of life will be held in a few months. David Westerfield, the mother of Mary, married to Todd Sparrow, has moved to the Springs at Stony Brook in Louisville. Please keep his wife, Jeanette, in your prayers as well. Christy Jane Hurst is having some health concerns related to her heart. Tommy Warford, brother of Roxy, who's married to Sammy Baumstark, has COVID concerns, was doing better, but has had a setback. Carrie Campbell, our nursery co-worker, has asked for prayers. She just found out she's pregnant with her second child, and her son Mason was just diagnosed with autism. We also add today Sharla Brumley Reed, the daughter of Chuck and Laverne Brumley. She fell and broke both of her wrists. We know that these and others will be on your thoughts and prayers as we go to God in prayer this morning. Let us pray. Healer of our every ill, especially our ills of separation and fear, we become before you to make our petitions known. Hear our cries for healing of body, mind, and spirit. We know that already you're at work among us, showing us the way to recover from the toxicities and grief of our time. As demolished pieces that are treasured when found, we trust that beauty from brokenness is possible when we seek to bind together that which is wounded. We pray, especially for those who have experienced the physical loss of family and friends in this pandemic. Amazing God, we ask people who are healed by Jesus, they were not afraid to ask. And so we come before the Holy One, making our petitions and desires known, trusting the work of the Spirit and those who are still suffering the consequences of the illness. We pray for each person who suffers in body in other ways. Weariness from inactivity or weariness from overactivity in this time. We pray for those whose treatment of sicknesses have been put on hold and those who suffer isolation or illness, whatever the cause. We pray grateful thanks for the medical staff everywhere around the world who have shown unbelievable strength and stamina. We mourn the demise of too many caregivers who risk their lives for our sake. We pray this day for so much more, O God. We pray for those in our community who are cold, who are suffering, who are trying to figure out where that safe shelter, safe water, and the next meal is to come from. We pray for those across this country who are suffering because of cold, who are without heat, electricity, clean, fresh water. And on this day, God, to all those in our thoughts and minds, those who are on our prayer list, those who are deep in our hearts and souls, whose names we utter only every now and again, but God, you know what those needs and wants are. And on this day, O God, we know that your love moves us, that you fill us as that vessel. Even though we may be broken, your love makes us whole. In all of this we ask in your holy name. Amen.
Thank you.
and sermon series for Lent 2021 is Holy Vessels. We are using the images of glass vessels and beach glass. Beach glass often begins as something whole and yet discarded. As it is tumbled by the sea, it is broken and polished until it becomes a treasured mineral gem. When brokenness and suffering enters our lives, we do not embrace that suffering as necessary or God-given. But suffering is a part of life. When pain and brokenness happens, Jesus reaches out to touch and remind us of the treasure we all are. Worthy of new life in the midst of hopelessness. In a year when pandemic has wreaked havoc on our world, we begin by affirming our journey to physical wholeness. Let us hear the witness of the Gospel of Matthew, the 8th chapter, the first 4 verses. When Jesus had come down from the mountain, great crowds followed him, and there was a leper who came to him and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, if you choose, you can make me whole. You can make me clean." Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him, saying, "I do choose. Be made clean." And immediately the man's leprosy was cleansed. Then Jesus said to him, "See that you say nothing to anyone, but go, show yourself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded as a testimony to them." This is the word of God for all of God's people. Thanks be to God. Well, leprosy is mentioned upwards of 40 times in the Bible. Leprosy was one of the worst and perhaps the most dreaded diseases of all time. If anyone ever came down with the disease, it was as if they faced a death sentence. Everyone who had the disease faced expulsion from society, including their home, family, friends, and anything else the leper had to leave behind. The leper was to wear special clothing. He had to live with other lepers in a colony. And whenever anyone came near, they had to shout, "Unclean, unclean," to keep the person away. We think how horrible that is. But the reality is we have shunned people even in our time. Many times when we should provide help, we simply send people away from our lives, sometimes casting them away to roam the streets or locking them away in jails, both figuratively and literally. The reality is caring is hard work. People who call themselves religious have often condemned others for what they view as going against their scriptures. I remember when I was growing up in high school, there was this girl who just disappeared in the middle of the school year. No one knew what happened to her. She wasn't close to anyone that I knew, so we all just kind of wondered. And years later, I found out that she had been sent away because she had gotten pregnant. Her parents couldn't stand the shame they perceived she had brought to their family and what the community might say if they found out. Caring is hard work. Roshini, name is changed, was outcast. She was called dirty and shunned by her village from the day that she was raped at the age of 16. She had to run away to Bombay City with a boy who abandoned her and their infant boy. Roshini then left her son with her widow mother in the village and headed to Pune City in search of work. The only work that she could find, the only way to support her family, was prostitution. Even though she did not like it, it helped pay for her son's food and education and gave her old mother a better life. Eventually, she tested HIV positive. And when her health began to worsen, Roshini retreated to her village, but soon she was asked to leave yet again that village. She happened to meet a social worker who brought her to an NGO, HIV/AIDS Rehabilitation Center in Pune. There she found hope. She found purpose. She found acceptance. She found love. She passes her days dressed in shapeless, loose-fitting clothes and helping other patients when she feels up to it, and spends time with her friends that she has made there. She affirms that it is better this way to live among others and not bring shame to her family. Knowing she does not have long to live, she desires to go back home for one last visit. But she has no way of knowing whether this time she would be accepted. Persons living with HIV or other diseases, the emotional, psychological, and spiritual support provided locally by a committed person can be an important resource for coping with their disease. People diagnosed as HIV positive or other things people find to shun someone can find that their lives are completely redefined with the dreadful attributes like denial, anger, isolation, depression, frustration, and even social outcast. How can we speak of a God of love in a situation characterized by pain and suffering, death, guilt, and hopelessness? How can we proclaim the God of life to people who live with death daily, cruelly and prematurely? How can we convince those who are ostracized, discriminated against, and not regarded as persons due to sickness such as HIV/AIDS, for which they may or may not be responsible? How do we convince them that they are daughters and sons of a loving and compassionate God? These are some of the painful questions which we Christians as individuals and as a community have an obligation to respond to. To care is to meet needs. This is the bottom line. Walson Thampu, in his writing, emphasizes care is more than charity. To care is to affirm the other. It is a positive statement of the value of human beings. Care in the outworking of love. Care, in turn, deepens love. It is basic to healing. During this pandemic, there are so many of us who have desired human interaction. This pandemic can help us understand biblical leprosy and shunning others from the community in some new ways. I think about how isolated some people are by their circumstances. Healthcare and retirement communities have completely locked down. Individuals are not allowed to leave their apartments or rooms. Food and mail and everything they need is delivered by individuals heavily masked. They are incredibly isolated and lonely. Some people who live alone have gone months without experiencing the touch from another person. We desire human interaction maybe more than we ever have because we realize what we have lost. And when I think about the reality, I understand a little better the isolation created by leprosy. I think of those who were labeled as lepers, who were to keep their distance and avoid touching or being touched. And in our day and time, loneliness was already a major issue in our society before COVID-19. The pandemic has only made it worse. We come to understand leprosy was not just a physical issue, but it was a religious, a political, a social one as well. And the same is true of COVID-19, is it not? When someone gets COVID-19, some blame the victim. Oh, they must have not followed the guidelines. And wearing a mask or not wearing one is not merely a public health issue, but in some places, it's a political statement. Looking at all this deepens our understanding of the ways that Jesus' healing was holistic and addressed many different things at the same time. Walter T. Wilson has written an excellent book, Healing in the Gospel of Matthew. He says this: viewed in the shadow of the cross, Jesus' ministry of healing can be seen and as an extension of his solidarity with human suffering, especially the suffering of those who have been abandoned by society. The bodies of those healed, meanwhile, are marked by the power of the divine to create new life out of hopelessness. Their stories representing new chapters in the rewritten narrative of human suffering. Becoming more whole does not mean that we are perfect. Indeed, it does not. Our holy vessels of body, mind, spirit, and community will always be diverse in form. In a culture where particular images of beauty and wholeness take precedence over others, we must offer a different vision of healing that simply proclaims new life out of hopelessness. We see that so clearly in the cross, a symbol that represents death and suffering, but also reminds us that Jesus is alive. The cross did not have the last word. Suffering and brokenness and even death does not have the last word. In Jesus, we have hope. In this season of Lent, may God take the brokenness in all of our lives and make something beautiful from it. A holy vessel. And may we as the church always witness to God's love, to God's acceptance of who we are and where we are in life, and to the healing power made evident through Jesus of Nazareth, our Savior. Let us pray. O God of every single person, in your love make us whole. May we rest in your compassion, Calm the lost, weary soul in the warmth of your love. May your peace fill our hearts. May we know the love of Jesus. By your grace, you console. Make us holy. Make us whole. Amen. We come to this table surrounded by vessels made beautiful. And we bring ourselves a holy vessel to this table during Lent. I like to think of Lent as a journey to the cross, where the cross is far off in the distance. But each Sunday, we become closer and closer to the cross. The cross of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who reminded us that it is not simply a symbol of brokenness, but it is a symbol of eternal life as well. Come, for all are welcome at this table. Let us pray the prayer our Lord taught, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Glory ever till my rapture. Jesus took the bread, he broke it, and blessed it, saying, "This is my body, broken for you. Eat in remembrance of me." Let us pray. Healing God, this is a time to remember that although we are broken vessels, you are with us to pick up the pieces, to heal, to restore us to an abundance of life. We eat this bread to remember our covenant with you and to celebrate that you live with us through worries and joys, through ordinary times and pandemics. We do not carry our burdens alone because you love and care for us. Thank you for being the balm we need to soothe our souls and the incentive we need to go forward in your footsteps. May we work to heal the brokenness in our corner of the world. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, let us eat the bread of life together.
Also that night in the upper room, Jesus took a cup, blessed it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take, this is my blood which has been poured out for the remission of sin. As long as you do so in remembrance of me." Let us pray. Divine Physician, you encourage us to draw near to you, to touch you, in Holy Communion with faith and hope. As our bodies and our minds thirst for your healing touch, I give you thanks for all you have provided for us through the covenant in Jesus Christ. As we partake of this cup, we are healed, we are redeemed. We thank you for this healing you sacrificed to give us. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us now partake of the cup.
Shackled by a heavy burden,
Christ that was in this place goes to all the places of the world. Let us pray. God, as we leave worship today, may we be that holy vessel that holds us and molds us and shapes us and shares with others, all those around us, the treasure that you've shared with us. May we go forth knowing that your love, your hope, your grace, and your mercy are evident in our faces today and every day. In your holy name, amen.